Hello everyone, it's Asia Marka here, Lemon Creation. Welcome back to my channel, or just simply welcome to my channel. I'm so happy you're here. Fancy some easy Christmas project? Here it is. Today I'm gonna start by coloring the page. I'm using Canson water paper because I'm gonna use a lot of water, a lot of paints, so the water paper is the best thing to go for. And I will be working with Lynn. This one spray is called Grease Lightning Green and the other Cathedral Pines Green. And I'm spraying, splattering. I actually had a nozzle which was clogged, so I replaced it with another one. I don't know if you know that Lindy's have in their store also replaceable nozzles, so they are breaking really rarely, but sometimes, of course, it happens. So if you're in need of a replacement, you can use them or you can buy them. I'm gonna add some magicals. I didn't dry my page because, you know, magicals dilute in water. So I decided to dilute it in the previously put down paint. And then I sprayed some water. I also, in the places when the powder didn't move, I used the brush to actually spread it a tiny bit more on the page. This is of course my technique, or rather just came to my mind to do it like that. You can do it whichever way you like, whichever way works for you. I can tell you that if you dry the paints in between the layers, you're gonna get some stains made with the paints, which you can gonna see in a few minutes. But that's the way also to do it. Then you have a more uniform mix of color. And what is great with playing with paints like that, and paints and powders, it's that you, depending on what you do, in which sequence, you're gonna get different results, and this is really beautiful. I add some black. This is not a very strong black, it's a Frolic in the Forest black, and like that I made the page a little bit darker, which I wanted because I'm making Christmas trees, so they are dark. And now I add a little bit more of spray, and that gave me these beautiful stains. Everything has a beautiful shine. And you know, you just tilt the page a little bit and you see the shine, you see the colors playing with each other. This is really great. And now I'm gonna be doing art journaling, so I kind of put my art journal beside the paper to have to know more or less to which size I have to cut my trees. So let's make it easier. I'm cutting the trees in the shape of long triangles. I will not do the single branches or anything like that. I find there is a beauty in buying geometrical figures, so that's what I'm gonna do. And what's the next step? The next step is to kind of darken the edges, because the fact that they are white, well, you can leave it white, but I think the project looks better and more realistic when the edges are darker. So that's what I'm doing, and I'm using archival ink because with it I am sure that it's not gonna run when I add some water later. And for the tree trunks I'm gonna use the same paper, but then I'm gonna kind of smudge it with the black archival ink. My first idea was to use a normal black paper, but to be honest, the black paper and the paper which is colored by paints, and it has more texture to it, the colors are changing, it was not a good connection, and so I decided to actually add more interest by coloring the green parts of paper with the black ink. And that makes the whole project more coherent straight away. And so I'm working on the cover of my, or inside cover of my notebook. I'm adding a layer of white gesso. And now I'm gonna add some shaker from Lindy's. This one is glittering gold. So, you know, Christmas project, there needs to be some gold. As I mentioned in one of my videos, my previous videos, I'm not always good at coloring or at adding paints to the project. And very often this is my problem, my bigger challenge. And I learn, or I learn and I like to add it with a piece of acetate. This is not even acetate, this is just a piece of foil. I like that way because it kind of, the paint goes where it goes. You have some control, not that much, and it gives you at the end this beautiful color stains, which you wouldn't paint with a brush, I think. So basically I found myself a trick which I'm using quite often and which I'm happy with. And so this is my advice to you. If you have problem with something, try to see other videos, try to see other techniques people use, artists use, and then maybe come up with your own thing which suits you the best. As you can see here now, maybe not very clearly, but I am cutting or making the trees a little bit slimmer. I decided that on my page they take too much place and they need to be slimmer. So I'm cutting them a little bit and again remembering to cover the edges with black archival ink. I made marks with the pencil and I'm gonna be stamping where the marks are to kind of show the level where the ground is. And this one are grunge dots from Joy Craft Stamps, and I want to stamp as much as possible of different stamps, but kind of keeping the stamps in line, or in the lines, few lines, just to really give the accent to the fact that the trees are not growing in one line, that there is some deepness to the page. My idea was to use also silver wire, not silver, golden, I'm sorry. And so I coil the wire around the trees. I forgot the word coil. I coiled the wire around the trees and I left the small piece hanging. So I decided to do it only on three trees. So like that, there is some disproportion in between them. They are not the same. Now I'm coloring just a piece of paper, again with the same glittering gold. And I will punch some stars out of it. Unfortunately, I didn't have a smaller punch or star punch because later I found out that the stars could be a tiny bit smaller, but that's what I had, so I punched three of the stars. And to make them a little bit more festive, I'm adding wax from Finavar. This one is aged brass. So I'm adding it with my fingers to the edges and tiny bit on the stars also. There was something bothering me with the stamps I've done, with the stamping I've done. The stamps, because of acrylic block, they didn't go all the way through to the edges of the paper. So I use Micron to add a little bit more of lines. And of course, it's me, so I'm adding lines, you know, I'm just doodling. They are not straight, they are not especially told off, you know, it's just lines. I will be gluing the Christmas trees in two different ways. With double-sided tape and also with a foam tape. This is also because I want to add layers to the page. So I made how do you call it? I made the ground on which they are standing, the trees, and then I made also the different levels because of the glue I used, and like that it looks more realistic at the end. So when you do project like that, don't be afraid to experiment a little. Don't be afraid to make the things go out a little bit of the page so they are not completely flat, and that gives straight away so much of a difference and so much of a better look in my eyes anyway. So after everything is adhered to the pages, I'm using a leaf adhesive. I absolutely love this product. It's glue, but it's watery. It's very, very watery. And I've decided to make an experiment for the first time. I've never done that before, and I've never seen actually anybody doing it, but I'm sure it's somewhere there in the on the internet. But I just sprayed it and decided to add some embossing, because I wanted a little bit of snowflakes on the trees. I'm using Lindy's Gang purely white embossing powder. So I didn't wait until the glue dries. I just spray it with a brush and then put the embossing powder on it. Embossing powder, because I couldn't use anti-static cushion, or I could have used before, but I didn't do it. So embossing powder stuck in other places also, a tiny bit on the wires, and but in general it stuck very well to the glue, and that gave me this beautiful snowy effect. I did not expect it's gonna look that good. Really, that was one of the best surprises in this project. I'm adding a little bit of again aged brass wax to the edges, a little bit of more doodling, just to make the ground more prominent, this time with a Uniball Signo pen, and I'm using a Wonderland cut die, no, die. I always have problem, I never know if it's die cut or die. This one is from Tin Lids by Tim Holtz, and I'm gluing it with head of the glue pen. By the way, if it comes to this embossing and using the leaf adhesive, if you don't have leaf adhesive, try to maybe just sprinkle the page with water and add some embossing powder, because embossing powder very often sticks well to the water also. Just do not put your heat gun on the high setting, you have to dry it very, very quietly. This is it from me. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Don't forget to hit the bell button to be notified about my videos. And I wish you a beautiful, beautiful day. Bye bye.